we're going to go through the steps of what it takes to extract a sample of your DNA. The first thing we need to do is actually get a sample of our cells so that we can extract the DNA from our cells. So we're going to use cheek cells to get a large amount of DNA that we can actually extract from them. The first thing we need to do is actually get a sample of our cheek cells. So I'm going to actually gargle my mouth with this water, and then that will move around enough epithelial cells from my cheeks to be able to get them out of my mouth. Okay, so in that water then, we should have enough epithelial cells for our extraction. So I'm going to pour the water back into my tube. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add some lysis buffer. Now in the lysis buffer, there is a detergent, and a detergent works just like soap does, or shampoo, or a dish detergent that we would use in our dishwasher. It's going to break down the components that is sitting in here in my cell extraction. So I'm going to add 2 mL of lysis buffer. And the detergent is going to start breaking down this extraction. So what the detergent will do is it'll break open 2 membranes. It'll break open the cell membrane on the outside of the cell, and it'll also break open the nuclear membrane, which of course is where our DNA is housed. So I'm going to gently invert this 4 or 5 times. And what this is going to do, it's basically going to get the detergent in contact with everything in the solution and start breaking open those membranes. We don't want to shake it too hard because that could actually break our DNA into small pieces and then we wouldn't be able to visualize it. So just a gentle mix is sufficient. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to add protease. Protease is an enzyme that breaks down protein, so that will start breaking down any large proteins that are still held together inside our solution. So I'm going to add 20 microliters of protease into my extraction. And again, I'm going to gently invert my extraction 4 or 5 times to thoroughly mix the protease. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to incubate my cell extraction at 50 degrees Celsius, and that is the optimal temperature for protease activity, and it's going to incubate there for 10 minutes. So our incubation with our protease is over. So we're going to take our cell extraction out of the 50 degree water bath, and the next thing we're going to do is add cold alcohol. And the cold alcohol is going to facilitate the extraction of DNA out of the solution. The alcohol is on ice. I'm going to add the alcohol at an angle and slowly add it in to our extraction so that the alcohol runs down the side of the tube. And I'm doing this slowly to create 2 layers, the aqueous layer and the non-aqueous layer. The combination of the alcohol plus the lysis buffer will allow the DNA to come out of solution so that we can visualize it. So we'll leave that extraction sit for 5 minutes undisturbed. So we've allowed our extraction to sit with the alcohol for 5 minutes. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to slowly invert my tube so that the alcohol layer mixes with the aqueous layer. And as I'm mixing, the DNA will come out of solution and will form an aggregate, and we'll see that aggregate as white threads at the interface where the alcohol and the aqueous solution meet. So when we stop mixing it, we can see the white strands in our extraction solution. And those long, thin white strands, that is your DNA. So once we have the DNA extracted, there are a few more experiments that we can perform. We can take the DNA and cut it into smaller fragments using restriction enzymes. We can also use the DNA in a polymerase chain reaction experiment to determine what sequences of DNA is in our DNA extraction. And these types of technologies are used in real-world applications, for example, such as paternity testing and forensic testing to determine the sequence of a specific fragment or sample of DNA that's found at a crime scene.